All right, second grade. So we're going to be doing our architectural duck drawing. You've learned all about ducks. You know we're not really talking about a quack quack duck. We're talking about a building that looks like what it sells inside. So I'm doing a fish market, and I know I want it to be in this city. But regardless of that, I'm going to have to start with a straight line for the bottom edge of my building. You need that straight line. Then I'm going to go ahead and for my fish, my building is going to be shaped like a fish. So it's going to come up, and I'm going to have it swoop up here like this. There we go. So there's the outline of my fish. Let's go ahead and I'm going to put my title here in the fin. So I'm going to just call it the fish market. Now, when you're writing, you want to write it before you box it in. So I wrote it. Now I know how much I can box it in. Next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to give myself a door. I'm going to put it back here, I think. I'm going to give myself a weird sort of rounded top door like this. And here's the handle. And I like that door. It works with the whole round theme. I put it up high, which means I'm going to need a way to get there. So I'm going to have to put some stairs or else you're trapped in there. And I'm going to make my stairs look like this. There we go. And I'm going to now go ahead. I probably should have a railing on here. So people don't fall off the stairs. That would be a lawsuit. That would be bad. Lawsuits are bad. So curving. And then I'm going to make it look like in here is netting, like a fish net, because it's fish. Right. So there's my netting. And maybe a little window in here. Again, I'm keeping with the curved idea. Eyeball. Need an eyeball on my fish, but I can make it look like a window. And I want to put the pane, like that. So there we go. What else do I want on here? Over here, I'm going to make this the Tall Tale Cafe, a little place to eat outside. So here we go. The Tall Tale Cafe. It's best if when you're making your titles, you use capital letters as if it's a sign. And these are going to be my pillars, and then I'll have that netting between these also. So here comes the net. I think having the curve in there really helps with the idea that it's a net, so I want to curve in there all of them. There. And then so really emphasize the fact that it is a cafe, I'm going to go ahead and do, there we go, those are the tables and all. The, not an awning, what am I thinking, umbrella. Thanks, guys. So here come my umbrellas. Got some tables sitting out here, there we go. So you can go up there and eat also. I can give you some indication that it's more that it's a fish. I don't have to fill the whole thing in, just giving it the indication. So there's my fish. Now the next thing I need to decide is where is it? Is it in the city or is it in the country? I'm going to put it in a city because I don't know that a restaurant like this would do a lot of business in the country. I don't know, might. So I'm going to go ahead and continue this line out here. Notice that it's sitting in the middle. It's not down here at the bottom of the page. And I'm going to add another line right here like this. And I'm going to draw some slightly diagonal lines to give you the indication that it's a, I hope you just said sidewalk, and that's usually built up from the road, so this is going to be the curb. There we go. And then I think we're good. This will be the street. So I'm going to give maybe some very skinny, because if you do the dotted lines, it's so skinny. They are not fat. Not fat at all. So there we go. Keep it, trying to keep it the same all the way across. Going off the edge of the page. So there's that. Now I need to have some buildings. So it's easy for the buildings that are behind here or even beside here. You know what I should have done? I should have put one of those spaces where they have trees growing out in the city. I'm going to add that. That's so cool. I sort of thought about that. I'm just going to add it in. There we go. Here comes my tree. And I'm going to have some tree limbs showing. And then there's the rest of my tree going like that. Okay, when I color, that'll take care of all that kind of stuff. So now I can go ahead and go in and put my extra windows and doors on my next building next door, which is this one. So I'm going to go with sort of want more of a double door. You sort of see a little bit of it. Put those little door handles on here. And it's going to be an office building, so I'm going to give it big, long windows like this. All right, so that building's done. What about what is behind here? Okay. Well, maybe I'm going to have a building right here you're going to see. But it's behind this. It's the next block over. So it's going to be very little smaller, and my windows are going to be smaller. So I'm going to have windows maybe only this big instead of this size. So I'm going to add all of these windows. I guess I should get some over here, huh? Don't forget to make things, draw partial things like right here that look like they're being just hidden by the, there's another partial one, by the tree or by here. Okay, I think you get the idea. You would finish out your windows. I'm going to put another building here, but I'm going to change my shape. I'm going to make it come up and sort of step up like that, and then maybe come down here like this. So there's that window, door, building. I can't speak. And I'm going to make that one look like it's even further away. I'm going to do that by making my windows only look this big. Now, the trick here is to make all of these marks that you have line up with one another, because they're getting smaller. Things that get farther away from you get smaller and smaller and smaller. Even if you can see it, we could even put a lower building here, like this, and do bigger windows. And that's showing you this one is in front of that one. Maybe I'll put like a little smokestack on there. Here's another one. So you get the idea that is in front of this one. But all of your windows, as I was saying, they need to line up. And that really looks like it's in the city and it's far away. And then I think I can put one more window. I need to have a parking lot, I believe. So I'm going to draw a line here. And I'm going to go ahead and put my building like a street here. And then my next building will be over here. So that's going to be probably in line with this one. So I would have more real small windows. Oh, maybe I should do these types of windows over here instead of that kind. So I'll make them look like this. Yeah, really small, like this. And I can keep doing that all the way down, and then I want to have really little doors down here. Look, really little doors. So again, this is going to be a parking lot. Maybe I'm going to put a little car in here, in my parking lot. So I'm going to need to have some spaces marked. They're getting smaller as they go back. Okay. Maybe you see a little part here of some more spaces. There we go. But we only have one car in there right now. It's nighttime. And you know how we know it's nighttime? Because I'm going to put a moon back here. There we go. So here is my picture. And I've shown you that it's a fish market. It's an architectural duck. It looks like what it sells inside. I've put it in the city You can tell that by all the buildings that are around. I even put a nice tree in here. So I have overlapping also. This building is in front of this one. This one's in front of this one. The tree's in front of here. All right. So I'm showing some overlapping size and placement. I'm showing you the time of day over here. So I think I'm really ready to start coloring at this point in time. So I hope you have fun with yours.